She knew the origin of the species was here. At some point, so did Edwards. He just refused to believe it. What happened to him? Given my luck with this place, I'm gonna guess those spores are poisonous. There must be some way to stop it for a bit. That did the trick. Die. Edwards marched his team into a death trap.
December 1932, I think. For any reason, we're having signal issues with the radios. There's a bloody electric current pulsing through the ice itself, totally blocking outward communication, even with the amplified radio. And who gets blamed for it? McCleary. Sorry I didn't pre-plan for absurdity. Don't know why we're still even here. You'd think watching Dakins get his spine ripped out by that walking horror show would warn us off. But everyone's obsessed with reaching the center of this place. Sure, call me a drunk, but I'm the only one here that has a clear head.
Believe me, I could use a drink right now, too. Okay. right. I barely made it out of there.
Nothing here. The sooner we will find the real evidence.
Look, we'll get to Antarctica.
We would have been there now if you had the courage to stand up to Edward.
Wait just a second.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean that. It's just... I need this. I can't do it alone.
You're not. I'll talk to her. I promise. I should have listened to her sooner. Looks strong enough. Hope it holds. Must be leading somewhere. What's heating everything up? Must be geothermal. Thank you. I needed that. Great. I could use a few extra bullets. I'm in the clear.
December 18th, 1932. To my surprise, I heard the voice of my beloved Victor this morning. I pray he survives the confounding horrors we've witnessed. This place changes people. Most of the crew is now delusional. They ramble about the Great One awakening, and despite having led them here, Edwards now wants to leave. His leg is growing worse by the hour and slowing us down. Well, I'm not leaving. All of our work points to the center. There is no turning back. This won't be like Chile.
She's gotta be up ahead. It looks just like Chile.
This again. I've gone over every detail religiously. Chile is the answer.
It's a ghost hunt.
Know your place, Miss Thorne.
It's certainly not behind you.
Victor, you should really reconsider me.
Drop it, Edwards. If you have the right to ignore her work, then she has the right to question yours. Go on ahead. We'll catch up with you.
Very well.
Botanists.
Then this Chile trip would make a lot more sense. Wait, do you hear that? Edward?
What is it?
Ava, come back! Help her! Over there!
You have to come see this. Can you see it? Over here, Victor. Don't be afraid. I'm waiting. He's lying. Don't let them stop you.
Stop this! Let go of me! Get out of my head!
Thank you.
get rid of these images from my mind. The way the crew members died. The way the creature's doing with them. Something is there at the center of the city. Something powerful. This thing they call the Great One. Was it controlling all of them? Is it controlling me? The visions, Ava, are they simply a string used to pull me closer to it? I don't think so, but then again, how do I know these thoughts are mine?
What was that back there, Edwards?
This place is clouding us. You know the...
What happened? Was Ava with them?
No, no, she wasn't. Ava's missing. She split from the group days ago. I didn't want to tell you because I knew you'd get yourself killed over it. Now, please, just get to the coast. The only way we'll be able to find her is together.
Oh, no. No, he's lying. What has he done?
December 20th, 1932. Edwards is a coward. Leaving on the cusp of something so monumental, it is madness. We knew before we came that this place was potentially dangerous, but we did not know that it was our connection to ineffable cosmic wonders. Edwards fears this power. So be it. I will follow the Great One's call to its source. How often is man given the gift of locking eyes?
Oh, what in God's name?
Human.
December 20th, 1932, 10 p.m. My team continues to fracture. Hernan is the latest to succumb to madness. He's yielded to the pull of the Great One, leaving me to join the others. I should have never brought them here. I know that now. I suppose I always knew it.
I know that door.
We head south in the morning. There's room for one more, and we could use your expertise.
Ava should be the one who goes, not me.
Victor, how are your appointments with Dr. Heller going?
Don't change the subject.
And no one is denying her contributions. They are remarkable, especially for a woman.
Look, you can dismiss her discovery, but the fact is, there would be no expedition without her. You're just too vain to admit it.
That's quite enough, Mr. Howard. It's clear you are still not in the right state of mind. Good evening.
He never wanted her here.
At least Chile is warmer than Antarctica.
We promised not to discuss work tonight.
I'm serious. I've heard it's lovely this time of year.
Antarctica will be our next trip. For now, we need to trust Edwards. He's a good man.
Well, we choose what we want to believe, don't we?
Ava.
Speak of the devil?
There he is, spouting the word of God.
Our discovery of artifacts dot the southern...
Ava, turn around.
What? Oh! You're kneeling.
You're asking you to marry me. Yes.
Oh my God. Yes. Of course. Yes.
God damn it. What happened to you, Ava? Edwards is hiding something. You were right about him. He always saw you as an adversary. But in reality, you could put actual sense into his manic theories. Did you find something out there he wants to claim as his own? If he's hurt you, I will tear him apart.